Refinancing again. Network Capital Funding is offering a low 15-year fixed rate at 1.75% with a 1.94 APR. Incredible! Network Capital has built a reputation for saving people time and money with our unique process that's fast, simple, and secure. Our 15-year fixed rate is 1.75% with a 1.94 APR. Now, second chances don't come often, and you may never see these rates again. So, refinance it and forget it. That's a 15-year fixed at 1.75%. Yes, 1.75% with a 1.94 APR. Call the experts at Network Capital now. Call 800-500-1-HIT. As in home run. Call now and save big on your refi. 800-500-1-HIT. 800-500-1-HIT.
If you want the best rate for your mortgage, look no further than American Financing, America's home for home loans. Whether it's a lower rate, access to cash, or even a new home purchase, they've got you covered, helping you save up to $1,000 a month. No pressure, no upfront fees. Call 800-777-8109 or visit AmericanFinancing.net. American Financing, NMLS 182334, NMLS ConsumerAccess.org.
Did you know the arrow in Amazon's logo represents A to Z? Maybe the My Computer Career logo should represent unemployed to employed. Ryan was out of work when he started classes in March. In September, he started his IT career working for Amazon, making more money than he ever thought possible. Here's a prime opportunity. Go to mycomputercareer.edu and take the free career evaluation today. You can start your new life as an IT pro in as little as 4 months. It's not rocket science. It's mycomputercareer.edu.
Southland weather from KFI. Cooler temperatures today and breezy out there. Highs in the low 70s along the coast. Mid to upper 70s for metro LA and inland OC. Upper 70s to low 80s for the valleys and IE. We're cooling down even more tomorrow. Highs will be in the 60s for some inland and coastal spots Monday and Tuesday. Right now it's 56 in Yorba Linda, 53 in Irvine, 55 in Burbank, 57 in Marina Del Rey. We lead local. Live from the KFI 24-hour newsroom, I'm Layla Muhammad.
Over 2,000 years ago, I walked this earth, teaching, healing, inspiring, and preparing to make the ultimate sacrifice. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whoever believes in him shall not perish, but have eternal life. What if today you and I could talk voice to voice and you could ask me anything? You are listening to the Jesus Christ Show.
Curious to know, or what, at what point do we get off track. And why is it that when you ask somebody what the gospel is, you get so many different variations of an answer?
Well, just because different people have different perceptions doesn't mean that there's different gospels, per se. I mean, you work, right, Michael? You go to work?
Correct.
Okay, and they see you one way, and maybe your family sees you another way. When you were in high school and you come home with your friends would see you one way, your parents would see you another way. But you're still only one person, and there is only one truth. You just are, you know, a little different in this sense, a little different in that sense, but it doesn't mean it's a different you. Now, the gospel, there's only one gospel, and it's simple. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whoever believes in him shall have everlasting life. That's the gospel. Gospel just means good news. The good news is that life can be rough, and there can be things that go on here, but there is a payment, a way out for the sins that are that people are accountable for here on earth. And that's through the death on the cross and the resurrection. That doesn't change. If anybody tells you something different than that, then it's not the gospel of Scripture, whatever they believe.
Right.
Now, if you're talking about the books, the gospels, Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John, that you have what you have, are called the synoptic gospels, Matthew, Mark, and Luke, meaning that they're similar in what they're describing. They're looking at similar accounts and describing them. And then John, which is slightly different and coming from a slightly different perspective. The hope is that taking all of those into account, you see the best picture possible through the eyes of man as to what took place or what the important thing is about that good news.
Right. I guess I understand that. It just seems kind of interesting because many people think that or feel like they have the need to go and perfect themselves in the flesh and kind of follow the Ten Commandments. And it's even, you know, we see so many people in the church who are basically, you know, trying to perfect their body here and they're using Christ simply for this life. And it seems like they're not interested in him for the next life.
That's a really interesting observation, and I'm not going to say that that's not true. Of course, there are people who do that, but they're not mutually exclusive. There's nothing wrong with here's the truth. You will not hit perfection in this world, but on the way, on that path to perfection, you can hit excellence, and there's nothing wrong with that. Nothing wrong with allowing God to purify you while you're here, to be the best you can while you're here. There's nothing wrong with that. You won't be perfect, of course not. But why not be a better you? Why not allow God to continue to cleanse you to be a better you while you're here?
Right. Yeah, you're right.
That's not something that it's beneficial to everyone around you. The Ten Commandments are there to keep you on that track. You should be checking yourself against them to make sure that you're not getting to a place of coveting people's, whether it's their husbands, their wives, their cars, their home. There's a lot of things that are good for you to keep in mind in the process of that cleansing. It says in Scripture that God alone is the author and the finisher of your faith. So not only is faith alone exists because of God, but also the purification process, the perfection of your faith, comes from God as well. And part of that takes place while you're here on this earth. But if you get lost in church and it's just about, well, being the best you, and you see all these kind of, I know they're very popular, when you come across television preachers are very famous, often selling lots of books, a lot of it has to tie into things that seem more like motivational speaking than it does about the gospel.
Right.
And I get that too. I know that it's like it's missing the mark a little bit. But that's part of the process as well, getting people on board to understand that there is things to be learned and to be utilized and applied to your life here in the now. Otherwise, God wouldn't put you here. Michael, you're here. Did he put you here just to wait to get to heaven? No. There's stuff to do. And part of it is purification.
Right. I totally agree. It just seems like a lot of people are wanting to justify themselves based on their work that they do here.
Yeah, that's human nature. You're right. It does happen. It happens a lot. People get lost in the work and looking at what people are doing and how they're doing it and forget the entirety of the process. But fruit on a tree does play a part as well. You know, scripture says that if you don't have, if the tree isn't bearing fruit, there's a problem. So there should be good work coming from somebody who believes. Now, they don't get to heaven based on them, but there should be good work, just like a healthy fruit tree should bear fruit.
All right. Well, what are the good works that we should be seeing coming from people who believe that Jesus Christ is the author and finisher of their faith? And, you know, I believe the Bible says, without faith it's impossible to please God. So, you know, what are those fruits that we should be looking for?
There should be the desire to purify yourself. There should be a desire to share your faith, and not in a overbearing way, but in a way, as 1 Peter 3:16 says, to be ready to first sanctify Jesus as Lord in your life. And that's right. Moving forward, to be ready to give a defense and an answer to those who ask about the hope that lies within you with meekness and reverence. That is to say that when people ask you about why you are different, because of the things you do, whether you're helping those around you that need help, whether you are standing up for someone you don't know, whether you are not joining the hordes or the mobs or the masses that are going one way and you're going the other direction because you believe it to be the direction of God, when you do those things, those works, people will ask you, why are you different? Why at a funeral do you shed tears but still have hope? You know, why when you are struggling through a process of learning something or knowing something, do you still believe? All these things tend to push people back to you asking, well, why, how come you're able to do this when others are not? And you can point them to the gospel. And through that process, you are growing and purifying, yet you're passing that along to others as well. You're being a good person. You're learning to do those things that glorify God and show that you care.
That's great. Well, I appreciate taking my phone call.
Of course. Excellent question.
And I appreciate you lifting up Jesus, because it seems like you said earlier, a lot of these preachers on TV are more like lifeless now. Often don't even hear the name of Jesus or see them opening a Bible. So I appreciate what you're doing.
Thanks, Michael. And it's not to say that these preachers don't have a place. There are things. I mean, even Paul talked about the unknown God and the altar to the unknown God. And it wasn't about preaching Jesus in name, but it was about preaching me in concept to get people's attention. And sometimes there's so many distractions that some of these preachers use that as a tool to get people involved in hearing the truth before they can naturally reject it based on, oh, they said Jesus, I'm running the other direction. And that's fine. This is a whole different thing. All glory to God, of course, in all of these scenarios. But this is a different type of thing. We too, you know, use our own way to get your attention on this program in hopes of you maybe hearing some truth and learning some things. Me, I like to focus on the things that are of great importance. And if this venue allows us the opportunity to talk about those in a comfortable manner, then praise God and all glory goes to Him. You are listening to the Jesus Christ Show. To ask this question,
pandemic reminded us we live in a sea of airborne germs that can assault us with every breath. Your nose is the body's first line of defense by helping filter out allergens, bacteria, and viruses before they reach your lungs. But like any air filter, the more clogged up it gets, the less it works. So how do you clean your nose? I'm Martin Hope, and I didn't invent nasal irrigation. The neti pot's been around thousands of years, but I did invent Navage to make cleaning your nose easy. Navage uses powered suction to flush out mucus and germs that cause congestion, or worse, can make you sick. Over 2 million people use Navage to breathe better, sleep deeper, snore less, and feel healthier without drugs. Navage has over 70,000 online reviews averaging 4.7 stars because it works and is easy to use. Go to Navage.com or find Navage at Walgreens, CVS, Rite Aid, Bed Bath, and Target. Now available with eucalyptus for a spa-like experience. Navage. N-A-V-A-G-E. Clean nose, healthy life.
This report is sponsored by MGM Resorts. At MGM Resorts, we know this is no time to return to normal. It's time for the time of your life in Vegas at MGM Resorts.
Don't miss Hulu's new original series, Don't Sit, an investigative thriller from executive producer Danny Strong. Discover how one company triggered the worst drug epidemic in American history and then tried to cover it up. Watch how it all began in the boardrooms of Big Pharma, ravaged small-town America, and made its way to the hallways of the DEA. The series stars Michael Keaton, Rosario Dawson, Peter Sarsgaard, Caitlin Dever, Will Poulter, and John Hoganacker, and Michael Stuhlbarg. Watch the first three episodes now and catch new episodes Wednesday on Hulu.
I'm attorney Darren Cavanoghi from 1-800-NO-COUNT. Can you do the alphabet password? Z-Y-X-W-V. Yeah, try doing that by the side of the road. So if you get pulled over, don't wing it. Call us at 1-800-NO-COUNT.
Now, when the news channels start using terms like quantitative easing and now tapering a lot, you know there's trouble ahead. What does it mean? Well, despite everything you hear, it just means less money in your pocket. Fewer dollars to spend. Everything costs more. Food, gas, utilities, all going up. Does anything cost less than last year? It's bad enough if you're young, but if you're close to retirement, it could be a disaster for your savings. A gold or silver IRA or 401k with Noble Gold will solve this inflation problem for good. And they're giving away a free 5-ounce solid silver America the Beautiful bullion coin with each qualifying plan you start this month as a thank you. Not bad, huh? The best part? You'll speak to an expert. No hassle, no pressure. Just a look at your options and what you can do to stop the Fed stealing your hard-earned money. Visit NobleGoldInvestments.com or call us at 877-646-5347. Did you know the arrow in Amazon's logo represents A to Z? Maybe the My Computer Career logo should represent unemployed to employed. Ryan was out of work when he started classes in March. In September, he started his IT career working for Amazon, making more money than he ever thought possible. Here's a prime opportunity. Go to mycomputercareer.edu and take the free career evaluation today. You can start your new life as an IT pro in as little as 4 months. It's not rocket science. It's mycomputercareer.edu.
Refinance to today's low mortgage rate, and you could save up to $1,000 a month, plus tens of thousands in long-term savings. It just takes a 10-minute call to American Financing to get started. You'll get a custom loan with incredible savings. No pressure, no upfront fees. Pre-qualify for free at 800-777-8109 or visit AmericanFinancing.net. NMLS 182334, NMLS ConsumerAccess.org.
Side of the 101 just before you get to the 110 freeway. They were saying on the left of the shoulder, but now two right lanes are blocked off as they try and clean things up to traffic back in up there. So coming away from Alvarado, the good news is they did clean up the mess in South LA. 110 freeway southbound side just before you get to Adams, two right lanes there have been reopened and your drive is backed up pretty good speed as you come through that stretch. And there's road work in Ontario 10 freeway is shut down both directions between Euclid and 4th Street until 10 o'clock this morning. Late eastbound as you approach Euclid, westbound as you're coming up on 4th Street, just take the 210 or the 60 instead. KFI and the Sky Help get you there faster. I'm Rebecca Campbell.
Ain't no sunshine when she's gone. It's not warm when she's away. Ain't no sunshine when she's gone. And she's always gone too long. Anytime she goes away, I wonder this time where she's.
show. I am your holy host. Happy to be with you this Sunday, as I'm with you every single Sunday. Right here, answering your questions and talking about the things that truly matter in life. And, of course, the afterlife. I'd love to hear from you. If you have a theology question dealing with God, religion, spirituality, worldviews, the Bible, or if you're going through something in life, we call them life situations. And I think we know everyone's going through something right now. I'd love to hear from you. The number, 800-520-1534. That's 800-520-1534. You can also follow us during the show and during the week at Jesus Show on Twitter, at Jesus Show. There was an article that came out. I won't get into all the details of it because it's not... It's one you probably heard many times before. With each new generation or each new group, an article comes out about how they're rejecting religion. Now, I'll tell you that it is the norm. Every younger generation wrestles with the faith of their fathers. And I use that as the term. I mean, the faith of their mothers as well. But in that process of growing and wanting to find themselves, there is a lot of pressure to adapt to what other people are doing as well. And if it looks to be just a thing for adults, if it looks to be something that doesn't seem to understand modern times, then by definition, the faith and the belief just becomes ancient. It looks ancient, it sounds ancient, it is ancient. I want no part of it because I'm modern. Now, it is the age-old problem of the adults and those that have practiced the faith to not want anything to change. And the youth that need the faith but don't want to practice it in the old ways want to see it modify and grow. And this happens in Scripture. There's stories of a new temple being built, and all the old folks didn't like it because they remember the way the temple used to be, and that's what they loved. And then the younger generation loved it because, well, it's more modern, it has all of these things. I will tell you this. If religion does not grow, if it is not living, breathing, if faith is not something that, like a branch of a tree, continues to grow and change and be pruned and bring forth fruit, it will die. You may not understand the ways of the youth or the desires of the youth. You may not understand their wants. But I will tell you this, without it becoming some sort of liberal belief, and I don't use that in a political sense, but in the sense that you just want to pull apart Scripture to the point where it's wishy-washy and it means nothing and no one's accountable. Nobody wants that, and I would never call upon that. Surprisingly enough, people that listen to the show think that it's going to be a mockery of faith and that are surprised at the hard line we do take on things that are important. But also, hopefully, on the flip side, you learn something, and when we talk about things like homosexuality and the laws and marriage, that you see things different as well, and that you learn and that you're capable of growing and understanding that there's something different about being a Christian versus being an American, and learning all of the variables in between, so that there's growth. And I tell you these things because you, if you are on the older spectrum, need to understand what the needs of the younger spectrum is and learn to adapt. And you, on the younger spectrum, need to know that if you water it down to where it has no backbone, it will have zero value to you now or in the future. And in the process of watering something down, it loses the entirety of its value. There's a point where if you put the old joke about going to Las Vegas and then watering down your drink, that you put enough water in the beverage, it's no longer an alcoholic beverage, it's now just water. And to do that is to remove all of the power of what Scripture has. So may the balance be met by both of you. You are listening to the Jesus Christ Show. To ask your question, dial
24-hour newsroom. Former President Bill Clinton has been released from UC Irvine Medical Center. Clinton has been there since Tuesday to receive treatment for an infection. He was in Orange County to attend events for his charitable foundation. A strike has been averted for the International Alliance of Theatrical Stage Employees and the Alliance of Motion Picture and Television Producers. A strike would have shut down film and TV production. A three-year deal was agreed upon yesterday. That deal includes 10-hour rests between shifts and 54-hour rests on weekends, as well as a retroactive 3% pay raise. News brought to you by Rooter Hero. A former chief Boeing test pilot has pleaded not guilty to charges he lied about the safety of 737 MAX planes. Mark Faulkner was in federal court Friday in Fort Worth, Texas. His attorney, David Gerber, says prosecutors are trying to find someone to blame.
If the government takes this case to trial, the truth will show that Mark did not cause this tragedy. Mark did not lie. And Mark should not be charged.
Prosecutors say Faulkner's choice to lie to the FAA during evaluation put passengers at risk. He's accused of giving false information about a part of the flight controls that later was a factor in two deadly international crashes that led the planes to be grounded around the world. Let's check traffic right now. We have a problem on the 101.
On the southbound side, just before we get to the 110 freeway, they've blocked off two right lanes now so they can clear up the debris from this earlier crash. The traffic is pretty heavy coming away from Alvarado, but once you get onto the transition there to the 110 south, things look pretty good. They canceled the signaler 110 southbound at Adams. Two right lanes there have been reopened, and your drive is back up to really good speed, so you're not going to see any delays through that stretch. They're doing roadwork overnight in Ontario, so they will wrap up at 10 o'clock this morning, but the 10 freeway is shut down both directions between 4th Street and Euclid. So the westbound side is slowing down. This is coming up on 4th Street. They'll put drop the freeway there to the Silver Street. And then eastbound side is slowing down. You come up on Euclid and finding pretty heavy delays both directions on Euclid as they're taking the 10 freeway down. That will wrap up at 10 o'clock. So if I'm in the Skyhawk, this is Jeff Foster. I'm about to go on the
KFI highs in the 70s along the coast, also for Metro LA and Inland OC, around 80 for the valleys and IE. Wheeling locals live from the KFI 24-hour newsroom. I'm Layla Mahoney.
This report is sponsored by Southern California Edison. Southern California Edison wants you to know that ground wires are dangerous and that you can never put water near a ground wire because it can be electrified. Stay away and call 911. Stay alert, stay safe. Learn more at fge.com/stay safe. By the year 2035, nearly half of today's occupations and some industries will be gone. It's because of rapid changes coming our way thanks to disruptive technology. Join host Rick Edelman for a virtual event, The Truth About Your Future, on October 19th at 3 p.m. or 8 p.m. Eastern. This valuable presentation is designed to help you understand the coming changes that will reshape everything from tax laws to how you live, work, and prepare for retirement. Please go to EdelmanFinancialEngines.com to register for this free event. You'll discover the potential opportunities